Right now, the ABC15 investigators with new leaked videos from inside Arizona prisons.
And these videos are extremely violent, so consider this a warning in case there are young children in the room. You're about to see two brutal assaults inside two different prisons, but the separate attacks highlight the same major security risk. It's a problem we first told you about 2 years ago. Tonight, ABC15 investigator Dave Biskoving continues to expose our state's dangerous and dysfunctional prison system.
It's November 3rd, 2020, and you're looking at a pod inside the Tucson prison at 9:55 in the morning. A lone officer checking a cell. Two inmates then corner him and unload. One holds him as another wails away, punch after punch after punch. Another inmate just walking around as more exit an upstairs cell, and another comes from the bottom of the screen. After about 15 seconds, the officer breaks free and begins to spray the inmates. They run and scatter. Think it's all over? Not even close. Just wait.
Historically, there should be staff rushing in already. If you're fully staffed and you called what they call the incident command system. However, that did not go down.
Carlos Garcia is a union director and former corrections lieutenant.
This is a pretty brutal assault.
Brutal. This is beyond brutal.
After spraying the inmates, the officer, still alone, and inmates begin to attack him again. Punches, kicks, stomps.
I mean, this guy's lucky he didn't die.
They were going for a kill, so literally, these inmates should have been pursued for attempted murder because they do everything, including kick his head like a football.
As a third joins in, this inmate appears to have hurt his foot. After a kick in the head, he limps and has to walk it off.
He's like taunting him now. Oh, he's hitting him. Yeah. He's at that point, he's just at their mercy.
The inmates get tired and actually take a short break as the officer gets to the stairs. There, the inmates go after him again. One even tries to use his own spray can against him. The punches, kicks, stomps just continue.
Meanwhile, there's no response from staff, and the attacks continue.
We're at a minute 45 of this now.
Yeah.
Now, we'll get to why no backup has responded here in a moment. But first, you should know something more about these inmates.
Here's one more thing to consider. The inmates that you're watching are not normal inmates. These are what they call in the department with their terminology as an override inmate.
Garcia says some of the inmates you saw are supposed to be level 5 maximum custody inmates, but they're in lower level security units. Their security level lowered in what's called a quote override. Here's another example. June 21st. Florence Prison. Garcia says this override inmate has a job he shouldn't have, working in the kitchen with a lower level of security. This video has no sound, but there's an officer off to the left here. Something causes the inmate to chuck a food tray, then move in. They're both off screen for a couple of seconds before you see a water cooler fly by, and then begin to see a vicious attack take place. Kick after kick after kick, followed by stomp after stomp after stomp. Those smears, blood from his shoe. The inmate then kneels down to deliver more blows. The officer isn't moving. He needed CPR and was airlifted to the hospital. From the start of the attack until backup arrives, 30 seconds pass. Now compare that to the attack we showed you first inside the Tucson prison. That assault spans a full 2 minutes without backup arriving. At the end, the officer finally gets away. The inmate with the gas canister chucks it as another officer arrives, followed quickly by a few more.
So here's the secret. According to the interviews with the appropriate personnel, there was a person that was watching him who was not from that unit. They were so short, they called another unit and said, come help us. They put that individual in that spot. When they tried to call for help, the radio did not work. It was busted. So they tried to call on the phone, no response, okay? This person had to call their own unit that they originated from saying, I'm desperate here, I'm watching an assault, and I can't reach anyone. I have no radio, the phone, I don't know what's going on. So the other unit now has to relay to this unit, you've got an assault going on. They're already short, 3 people show up, God bless them, but what you should have was at least 8 people running in here.
I'm Investigator Dave Biskoving, ABC 15, Arizona.
What you just saw may not even be the most troubling aspect in all of this. Dave discovered the inmates in the Tucson assault were never referred for criminal prosecution until he started asking questions. Here's a timeline. November 3rd, 2020. That's the date of the assault, 8 months ago. Then in mid-June, we obtained the video and began working to verify details. June 17th, we reached out to the Pima County Attorney's Office to ask about the case. June 22nd, the County Attorney's Office calls us back to tell us they never got the case. So they reached out to prison officials to ask about it. Late June, Arizona Department of Corrections, Rehabilitation, and Reentry finally sends the case to prosecutors to be charged. Prison officials did not answer our specific questions about these assaults and the override issues. In a written statement, a spokesperson says the environment that our correctional officers work in on a daily basis is challenging and potentially dangerous. We do everything in our power to control this environment and are extremely proud of our men and women who serve in these vital public safety roles.
Drugs.